So let's start with the weather tight and water tight. So weather tight, as the name suggests, it can withstand the weather, the forces of weather, sea, spray, any seas, green seas are coming on the ship, waves and all, in any weather condition, its weather is not defined. So water should not come out from the weather side to inside the cargo hold or accommodation. So from outside to inside, the water should not flow. That is your weather tight. So weather tight means in any sea condition, water will not penetrate into the ship. A weather tight fitting shall have a strength equal to its bulkhead or deck, whichever it is fitted. In practical terms, the difference between, so if a bulkhead is B class bulkhead, your weather tight opening should be also with so much strength that it can withstand the B class strength which is required for holding the water or the stuff. And the main difference between weather tight and water tight. So water tight means, as an name suggests, watertight from both the sides. So watertight, it has to withstand water from both the sides. So watertight fitting shall withstand water pressure from, weathertight should withstand water pressure from outside, and watertight filling shall withstand water pressure from both the sides. And also it requires a head of 15 meters. So watertight openings, they are pressure tested for a head of up to 15 meters, which they can withstand from both the sides, outside and inside. And weather tight is only for allowing water, and there is no height of water because it cannot withstand the pressure. So that is the main difference. Now let's see. So these are the features of watertight and weathertight doors. This is weathertight, example of weathertight door, and the other one was watertight door. So weathertight doors are unidirectional, and this is the ship. So ships on above the waterline are exposed to this heavy weather, and cargo and accommodation should not get affected. That's why they are designed weathertight. Watertight doors are below the waterline, so they are exposed to a lot of pressure of height of water. So they are tested like this to put in a tank and kept up to 15 meters of water height of the tank, and they are tested so that in case of any problem, water is not entering from one compartment to other compartment. So why we are having this? Because the ship's survival capability in case of any grounding, spill, collision, if the ship is not divided into various compartments, then all the compartments will get flooded and ship will sink. So what we want to avoid, if one compartment is flooded or bilged, then the others should not flood like we had in Titanic or others. So on passenger ships or some ships, because of some reason, if there is a passage in below the waterline, then all the doors should be watertight like this. So these are weathertight doors, which is above the waterline, and below the waterline we'll see watertight. So these are the watertight doors which are fitted on passenger ships and other ships which have openings under the compartments of different compartments under below the waterline like this. Because passenger ships accommodation is below the waterline also, so they have to go for access from one another. But in case of flooding, they should have watertight doors to prevent flooding from one compartment to another. Also, there is a requirement for this watertight doors to have an audio visual alarm while they are closing, which should start 5 seconds before, and they should close within 1 minute, and all the time this audio visual alarm should be working. And they should also be operated from manually and also remotely from bridge and emergency control station in case of flooding. Also, they act as a for preventing passage of smoke. In case of fire, you can prevent. So smoke, water, nothing will go from one side to another if they are closed. So if the ship is sailing or in heavy weather or any flooding, so it will be saved if only one compartment is flooded. That is our damage stability criteria. So we saw the testing method for watertight doors by putting in the tank, and the testing method for weathertight doors or accommodation doors is just applying a water hose, and one person stands on the other side and sees if any water is coming. So water hose testing is for weathertight doors, and tank pressurized with water testing is for watertight doors. Then these are different watertight door designs. You have a wheel and which has locks from all the sides, all booby hatches like this with wheels you have in your engine room for duct keel entry. Then you have dog legs with watertight doors with handles, and dog legs are watertight with portholes also, weathertight, sorry. Then we have some gas tight design. So for gas tight, they have all the dog legs inside. So basically, as per load line regulations, we want to calculate the survival of the ship, and for that they have a designed freeboard of the ship. The place, the distance from waterline to the brimstone line. For deciding this freeboard, they have assumed a criteria that your uppermost continuous deck, that is this main deck or the uppermost continuous deck or the weather deck, is a continuous deck. There is no opening. It's a continuous watertight deck. But this is not possible. We have so many hatch covers or booby hatches on this, and we cannot avoid that because of cargo. So what as per the load line, what they suggested is that if you raise the some combing height of this hatch covers or hatch combing, and then you put them and then you make them weather tight, so it will be okay, because now they are not, if the combing height is raised, they are not part of the uppermost continuous deck, and if any weather or water is accumulating here, it will not go directly into the hold. So that's why they gave a combing height which is called sill here, the sill height or sill space. So let's see the requirement for combing, which can allow us to make some openings weather tight. So we can see here that this sill requirement for RoRo type ships is 380 mm. So from the vehicle deck, above 38 mm only can be your door access doors or hatchways to the spaces. Then if we see this combing height for side curtains, it should be 2.5% of the breadth, or 500 mm, whichever is greater, above the summer load line. Then the main thing is, if you see for the other doors, so for accommodation doors, which are from the bridge up to poop deck, the height of the combing should be at least 380 mm. And if you see for the other doors on the poop deck or anywhere on the freeboard deck, the height of combing should be at least 600 mm. Same if you go further, you will see that the height of combing for hatch covers required is around 1 meter. So this way, the openings which have a combing height above this 300, 600 as per the requirement, 1 meter, they can be weather tight because they are not having any head of pressure, and also we are not having any water inside. So they are only exposed to water and they need to be weathertight only. But the ballast manholes and fuel oil manholes, they have water also inside or liquid also inside. So they need to be watertight, and for watertight there is a they have made a requirement that you make it almost flush with the deck, you put a gasket and you put closely fitted nut bolts. It is around 2 centimeters, 1 inch gap. We need to put closely fitted manhole. There is a requirement in detail. So if you have closely fitted manhole covers, they will also be treated as uppermost continuous deck or watertight only. So this is all about the requirement of your weathertight and watertight. Your manholes covers above waterline are watertight, and all other openings of your hatch covers and booby hatches and accommodation doors are weathertight.